Right, I don't know what number this is, could be 6, 7. That's the entrance to Cheddar Gorge there. Before it gets all rocky. This is called Blackdown Rock all round here, where the quarry is down there. There's a quarry there. I think it might still be used for quarrying, I'm not sure. I normally pass that when I'm down in the, walking on the track down below there. And I follow that lane up there. And of course, leading up round here, you've got Velvet Bottom. There's Longwood over there, look. Long field over there with the sheepers on the other side of the wall. Yeah, this has been a, what I call a short walk today. Even though it takes several hours, it's still classed as short. I mean, my long walks. Well, I don't really start much before 9, but I might have to change my plans a bit in the winter. It's just so beautiful, isn't it? And there's probably other walk. Well, over there, that's where I climb up there to get on top to walk along the other side of the gorge, that bit there. So I have done that bit. Here we've got another marker. What's this, 5? Oh, 4. Yes, we're nearly back to our... Well, it won't be the start point because that's down there in the valley. And I'm heading that way. But I reckon you could probably walk along here. Above Velvet Bottom to get to Oobley or Ubley Warren, which is where a lot of the lead mining took place as well. There's also swallows, potholes, sinkholes. I've seen them, I've taken pictures, I've seen the entrances to those other caves over there. On previous videos I've done, I've taken pictures of the locked metal covers. God, I say those crows are big. They look more like ravens. So there we've got our lovely Longwood there, look. Which has also got a marked walkway for people. Full of bluebells and wild garlic in the spring. Potholes in there, I've met some cavers. Yeah, it's all so beautiful. We're very lucky to have this. And of course, every country's got its beauties. See, there's sheep in that field, that one there. So, there is probably an allowed way through that you can go along the top and then come back up the valley. Which is what I was looking for. When I asked someone, I said, oh no, you know, people tell you rubbish really. Because they haven't done the walk, or they haven't explored. So as far as they're concerned, there isn't a top walk. Yeah, I can see some people walking along there. That's a walkway I do sometimes. Could be that the cows have been taken in now. I can only see sheep, although those big woolly cows were out. Yeah, I expect to see this pile of stones there. This here was probably a home, a miner's hut or something like that, a shepherd's retreat. Very likely. Private land, no public right away. Please keep gates shut at all times. No public right away, so we won't be going there then. Yeah, see, this is where the sign, we have to take it for granted we go down here, by the way. A lot of it, why they don't let people in, is because it's riddled with potholes. And the farmers would probably be expected to cover them up. Well, it all costs money, doesn't it? So if they just warn you not, it's private, and keep off. There we go, we just follow this. This is, looks like everyone walks this way, doesn't it? Right then, over and out for now, everyone.